When Neofetch developer decided to quit coding and went farming, that void was quickly filled by Fastfetch. Wait a sec. You know what these Neo, Fast, Screen Fetch things are, right? No? Well, these CLI tools display ASCII logo of your Linux distribution along with various system details. You will often find it in the screenshot shared on popular Linux forums like Reddit and its FOSS community. Anyways, Neofetch was perhaps the most popular and is now discontinued. So we have a worthy replacement in the form of Fastfetch. And if you're thinking why I'm making a video on a tool that only displays the fancy looking logo and some system information, you have every right to do so. See, Fastfetch is extensively configurable and you can customize it to your liking and have more fun with it and make your Linux desktop screenshot more oomph-worthy, if that's even a word. Let's see how to do that. You see, Fastfetch supports over 400 distro logos. Now, I don't know if there are any repetitions or not, but this is a good indication on the number of Linux distros we have. That should be like 200 or 300, which is like three distributions for every Linux user and hot Russians in my area. Well, you can use this to display logo of another distro in your system. For example, Arch users who could never manage to install Gentoo can take advantage of this feature and display a Gentoo logo in Arch. It's possible that the logo colors may not look good on your terminal, and in that case, you can configure the color or colors if there are more than one color in the distro logo. Why stick with distro logo? You can convert any image to ASCII text file and then display it with Fastfetch. Interesting, right? You can also display real images with Fastfetch, but not every terminal can do that. Some terminals like Ghosty, Kitty, KDE Console, Western, etc. support some sort of image display protocol. Like here, I display the image of my second child. After all, setting up kids' photo on phone is too mainstream. So we Linux users can certainly do things differently, right? All these changes can be made permanent by adding them to Fastfetch config file that I will discuss later. For now, know that Fastfetch elements are controlled by what's called modules. Now, if you want to display only a certain kind of information, just use those module names. You can create an alias if you want to use Fastfetch like this without changing the config file. I'll come to editing the config file in a moment. Before that, let me show you another magic with Fastfetch. It has a bunch of presets. So if you want to flaunt your customized terminal, you can use one of those presets, whichever suits your mood and setup. There used to be a, by the way, btw.json preset earlier that faked distro logo and name to Arch Linux. It seems that it is no longer available. So let's talk about modifying the looks of Fastfetch with its config file. For that, you must generate the config file first. Once you have the default config file, you can start modifying it to control what gets displayed on the screen. VS Code supports auto suggestions and autocomplete, so you may use it or you can stick with your favorite text editor like Emacs. If you feel stuck with the config file, man pages can be extremely exhaustive. Instead, you can check out the help page of genconfig or check out the format for a specific module. I think it would be wise to copy an existing preset into a new JSON file. Modify it, test it, and when you're satisfied, you can use it as default config. Before you do that, you should make a backup of the default config.json and then replace its content with your custom config file content. Or you can leave it as it is and set an alias to use your custom config by default. The choice is all yours. We have a few custom Fastfetch presets on our GitHub profile. You might have seen them in some of the earlier videos. If you want them, you can find the link in the description. So now you know a lot more about Fastfetch. Even if you're not customizing it on your own, at least you can use a different preset. I hope you learned something new from this video. That's our goal at its FOSS, to help you learn new things with Linux. Enjoy Fastfetch, enjoy Linux, enjoy its FOSS. Bye-bye for now, and I'll see you in the next video.